In this lecture, we're going to be talking about international trade. The syllabus includes discussing what global markets are and how they work, reasons for trade, and lastly, the trade restrictions that countries put in place for various reasons. Let's start by seeing how to model international trade in global markets. An import is defined as a good or service that is bought from international markets or other countries. An export is a good or service that is sold to international markets or other countries. Countries trade because of a concept known as comparative advantage. This is a situation in which a person or a firm can produce a good or service at a lower opportunity cost than another person. They may require less labor, land, capital, or entrepreneurship to produce that specific good than another producer. National comparative advantage is a situation in which an entire nation can produce a good or service at a lower opportunity cost than another country. Both countries that trade are better off because they specialize in the production of the good or service in which they have a comparative advantage, and import the goods in which they do not have a comparative advantage. As we will see in just a minute, both producers and consumers all around the world are able to benefit from international trade. Let's start with a basic supply and demand graph for any arbitrary good or service. We have an upward sloping supply curve and a downward sloping demand curve. At their intersection is the equilibrium price and quantity that will be produced and consumed domestically. Now let's say that the country opens up to international trade. We now see a horizontal supply curve that represents the world supply. It is assumed that the world can supply an unlimited quantity of a good or service for the same price. In this situation, producers around the world are able to supply this good for a lower price than our country's domestic producers can. We know this because the world supply curve is positioned below the domestic equilibrium price. This indicates that this good will be imported into the domestic country from foreign markets. The equilibrium price of the good will always be at the position of the world supply curve. Because the price has been lowered, domestic producers now produce less of the good. The exact quantity produced by domestic producers will always be the quantity at which the domestic supply curve intersects the world supply curve. Additionally, the new price brings an increase in the quantity demanded of our good as well. The new quantity demanded can be found where the world supply curve intersects the domestic supply curve. There is a problem though, and that problem is that domestic producers are unable to produce enough to satisfy the quantity demanded. This difference, indicated by the purple arrow, shows that shortage. This shortage is fulfilled by importing the good into the country. This shows us how much of the good is imported. Let's assume that we have another market for some other arbitrary good or service. Again, we see a normal upward sloping supply curve and a downward sloping demand curve. Equilibrium occurs where the supply curve intersects the demand curve. Now, if this country opens up to international trade, we see a horizontal world supply curve again. However, this time the world supply curve is higher than the domestic equilibrium price. We'll see why in a moment. The world supply curve, as with the market for imports, is also representative of the equilibrium price for this good, both domestically and in foreign markets. This higher price reduces the quantity demanded, as the law of demand predicts that it should. Thus, the quantity demanded of the good can now be found at the point of intersection of the world supply curve and the domestic demand curve. The higher price leads to an increase in the quantity supplied of the good, as the law of supply predicts that it should. The new quantity supplied is at the point where the world supply curve intersects the domestic demand curve, supply curve. Again, there is a disconnect between the domestic quantity supplied and the domestic quantity demanded. This supply surplus is exported to foreign markets. The purple arrow shows us how much of the good is exported.